Well, this is a boat. As mentioned, we used it as a caravan and also a houseboat. I'll just take you a little tour through it. This is the front section. It's got a new laser light roof up top, which is watertight. I've got tinted bistro blinds, so the roof and the blinds are all 99% UV filtered. This is a sea lounge, which also converts to a huge king size bed quite easily. The little flaps come up there, as you can see there, and we've got the spare cushions, which at the moment we've got sitting behind that false wall at the breakfast bar, the bamboo wall. And I'll take you in and show you that in a minute. Underneath the sea lounge, there's ample storage under the whole thing. So there's plenty of storage in the front. It's a great place to fish, even the front. The hull is a catamaran hull. Very, very stable on the water. Extremely stable. We don't even bother putting things away. Off the benches, everything stays in place. It's 20 foot in length. The trailer is completely galvanized except for this one front bar that's been added onto it, which is rusted out, as you can see. The rest of the trailer is in good condition. So this bar needs to be replaced. As you can see, it just bolts on, so no welding involved. And the purpose of this bar is just to hold up the stoppers, which stops the boat from moving forward in transit. The other problem with the trailer is that the brakes are disconnected. Don't know why, we never bothered with it very much, but for registration purposes you probably need to get that done. So the hull's fiberglass. The cabin's fiberglass. And it's very, very rigid, very, very strong. Right at the back there's two duckboards with a 25 horsepower Johnson motor on it, which we've recently had service and was a major service. The head came off and was all cleaned out and everything. On the side here there's just a table. I don't know if you can see that properly, which pulls out, which is great for fishing and other things. Okay, I'll take her up on board now. We've put a blind over this hatch here, just for a bit of privacy. And we're moving to the interior. Pleasure enter through the back. When you're in the water, the duckboard sits just above the water level, so it's a great place to swim from. People love it. Okay, so the sink's up the back. There's a breakfast bar here with two stools. At the moment we've got the extra cushions for the front section behind there, but we built it so a single mattress can fit under there and make a third berth for the place. So back into the galley. We've got the sink, there's a pump tap which pumps. We've had it pumping straight out of the lake because we're in a fresh water lake, so you can connect it to the water tank. It all needs a bit of a clean up at the moment. It's got a stainless steel marine stove and grill, cupboards down there, a two-way fridge. We run them on gas and it works absolutely beautiful. The freezer freezes and the fridge keeps very cold on 4, but it can go up to 8 if you want it even colder. Then, as you move through, on the starboard side we've got the shower and toilet. Again, we pump straight up from the lake for the shower, but there is a water tank in the closet next door. There's a little hand basin there and just a porta potty. And that's about it for the shower and toilet, really. And in here we have closet space and more space there, and the water tank just sits under here. This just lifts up. And there's a water tank there with all the hose connections. On top of the roof there's poly pipe, which has been mounted really nicely for solar hot water, and that heats up. Over here on the port side we have the steering wheel, forward controls, or forward controls, it starts and stops and runs from here. We have the electrical circuit board and the marine radio. The only thing that really lets it down in the galley here is these kitchen cabinets. They're very solid, but they look really rough on the outside, so if you could reface them, that would really bring it up fantastically, but they had to make a lot of storage space for the bits and pieces. And now we're back here in the front section of the boat. This is all built with hardwood, of course. The weight's not a problem, it sits perfectly in the water and runs really well. It cruises on about 7 knots on the motor. The motor's got a fairly good alternator in it because it's a nice charge to the battery. Under here in the galley there's a water separator filter and the ball pump, and that's pretty much it. We use it as a caravan when it's on the land, and we use it as a houseboat on the water. The boat's registered, and I can't actually see the month from here. It's got a fair bit of rego left on it, and the trailer is unregistered, so you need to get the trailer registered if you want to use it as a caravan as well. And yeah, that's it. We've had a great time in it, and we've had to see it go.